हेलो चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम टू सोशल साइंस क्लास। इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू चैप्टर 16, हु विल डू दिस वर्क। लेट्स डू माइंड मैपिंग। व्हेन आई से हेल्पर्स, विच वर्ड्स कम्स इन योर माइंड? यस, words like teacher, carpenter, doctor, plumber, painter, electrician, etc. Aims and objectives. To make the students understand that no work should be regarded as dirty or low. To know our helpers and appreciate their work. To understand the fact of equality irrespective of one's work, caste and creed. We live in a society where our work has been distributed among many people. These people are known as helpers, as they help us in our day-to-day work. Some of this work is considered as clean work, while other work is considered to be dirty. Different people do different kinds of work on the basis of their skill. This is known as division of labor. We must respect every work and the person who does it. This is called dignity of labor. Some jobs are considered low and disrespectful. The road sweeper, sewer cleaner, garbage collector, laborer, etc. These workers have to face foul smelling of garbage and suffer from many health related problems. The people looked at them with hatred and considered them as low. People don't want to do job of sweeper, gatekeeper, garbage collector, etc. because by these jobs, we earn very less and considered very devalued. The poor and backward people do these jobs as they don't have enough money to study and to get a job. If nobody would clear the garbage lying outside, then there would be a lot of garbage accumulate here and there. The place would become very filthy and give foul smell. A lot of mosquitoes and other germs would breed. Now, let's know about Mahatma Gandhi. Mahatma Gandhi, the father of our nation, believed that no work is high or low. He also stressed on dignity of labor. I'm sharing how people used to live in Gandhiji's Sabarmati Ashram. Mahadev Bhai, who was good friend of Gandhiji, his son Narayana was about 11 years old when he was staying in Gandhiji's Sabarmati Ashram. Like everyone else in the ashram, he had to do various kinds of work. One of his job was to teach the guests how to clean the toilets. Dear kids, in those days, the toilets were not what we know today. There used to be holes under which baskets were kept. People sat on the holes. Later, the basket had to be lifted by hand to be emptied. It was the usual practice that people from a particular community would do this work. But in Gandhiji's ashram, every person had to carry basket to the compost pit and empty it there. No one was excused from this task, not even the guest. Now, I am sharing one bhajan which was sung every morning in Gandhiji's Sabarmati ashram. It is written in Gujarati. वैष्णव जन तो टेढ़े कहिए जे पीड़ पर आई जाने रे पर दुखे अपमान सहे जे मन अभिमान न आने रे. इट मीन्स द वन हु फील्स द ग्रीफ एंड डिफिकल्टीज ऑफ अदर्स ही ऑल्सो टॉलरेट्स वो एंड इंसल्ट बट स्टिल डज नॉट फील प्राउड ऑफ हिमसेल्फ. Gandhiji used to wash the toilet himself and never considered any work inferior or superior. Now, I am sharing one another thing which is related to Mahatma Gandhi. Gandhiji went to stay at a village near Wardha in Maharashtra. Gandhiji, Mahadev Bhai and others started to clean the toilets in village. They did this for some months. One morning, a man coming from the toilet saw Mahadev Bhai. He pointed to him and said, "There is a lot of dirt over there. Go and clean that." When Babla saw this, he was very angry. He thought the villagers felt that this was not their work. This was for Gandhiji and his team to do. He asked Gandhiji why this was so. Gandhiji replied, "Untouchability is a serious matter. Lot of hard work will be required to change this." Narayan knew that the people who usually do this work were thought to be untouchables. He asked, "What is the use if the village people do not change their thinking? They have become used to someone else doing this work for them." Gandhiji replied, "Why don't you think the people who clean also benefit from it? They also learn a lesson. To learn something is like learning a new skill, even if it is a cleaning job." Mahatma Gandhi gave the low caste people a new name, Harijan, which means bold people of God. He worked for their upliftment and he himself lived with them in their colony to boost their morale and to urge the so-called upper classes to shed their narrow outlook and treat everyone as equal. The efforts of Mahatma Gandhi yielded good results and developed the feeling of self-respect and confidence among the economically weaker classes. Now, let's know something about Bhim Rao Baba Saheb Ambedkar. Bhim Rao Baba Saheb Ambedkar became very famous across the world. Baba Saheb fought for justice for people like him. Now, let's know one story about Baba Saheb. This story is almost 100 years old. 7-year-old Bhim went to Goregaon in Maharashtra with his father to spend his holidays. He saw a barber cutting the long hair of a rich farmer's buffalo. He thought of his own long hair. he went to the barber and asked for a haircut. The barber replied, "If I cut your hair, both my razor and I will get dirty." "Oh, so to cut human hair can be dirtier than cutting an animal's hair?" wondered little Bhim. After India's freedom, the constitution was prepared under the leadership of Bhim Rao Baba Saheb Ambedkar. Later, this little Bhim was also known as Bhim Rao Baba Saheb Ambedkar. He became very famous across the world. Baba Saheb fought for the justice of people like him. After India's freedom, the constitution was prepared under the leadership of Baba Saheb Ambedkar. Now, let's know some new terms. Untouchability. An old practice of touching a person belonging to a backward community is considered to be a sin. Ashram. A place meant for old people and saints. Constitution. A book of laws according to which a country is governed. Dignity. The state of being worthy of respect. Upliftment. Make more hopeful and happier. Dalav. A special type of big dustbin in which garbage is collected. Crane. A machine which carries huge garbage at a time. Children, I hope the chapter is clear to you. Thank you.